Hello again, friend. May your path be blessed.
Come now. You're half dead already. I'm merely helping you to your well-earned rest, while helping myself to your supplies.
In the name of all the world.
Gods. All you people talk about, glorious beasts, hear that. You have no vision, no ambition. Just so desperate to be ruled. Well, despite what so many think, you have never needed gods to guide humanity. Only the right man for the task.
Who are you?
The future you won't live to see.
Come on. How do? Name's Drustin. Hey, look at that. You're a lampy like me. Now can hurt us now we got these, eh? Wait till Melchior sees me next. I'll chop my own head off and come back and he won't believe his eyes. Melchior, he's my brother. He's a famous knight. He's fought dragons and giants and even wizards and all sorts. Those spiky baddies only got the drop on us because they cheated. I fell down and got knocked on the head. And when I woke up, Melchior were gone. And he'd never leave me. They took him. But not to worry. I'll get him back and be a hero just like him. Well, I best be off soon. So long, Lampy.
No! Several of our sacred texts tell of Saint Latimer, a noble knight, and most devout follower of Our Lady, canonized after he sacrificed himself to help show the hallowed sentinels what was necessary for the greater good. Many have given their lives to sustain the beacons, but Latimer was the first, and remains one of our most venerated figures. Our holy work continues, let Aureus's will be done.
There is a point at which pride and purpose become self-destruction and illusion, friend. But if you insist on continuing to punish yourself, then I suggest you venture into the woods. Unnaturally frozen and home to terrors they may be, but they also contain one of the beacons to which you've dedicated yourself. And who knows what other treasures might be found there beneath the snow and ice. Mornstead may be little but a blood-soaked ruin at this point. The truth is that the rest of the world isn't far behind on the same path. Even without the help of those grotesque Rogar, our world is more conflicted than ever, with men of all stations, nations, and creeds at odds. They need someone to unite them and lead them, before they all tear each other apart like dogs. You look tired, friend. Haven't you already suffered enough?
Radiance, judgment. Our Immaculate Lady will bring redemption.
Good thing I've got thick, sturdy boots, because crossing some parts of that burning ruin they call Lower Calrath is like walking on hot coals. Still, when you grow up in Perdam, you quickly learn what true heat is. I've never been too fond of fire. My grandfather used to tell stories about the Perdamish Crusades, and there was one about what the Dark Crusaders did to every man, woman, and child in one small village. That left an impression. They may worship Aureus, but it's clear as day why Judge Cleric parted ways with the Church of Aurean Radiance.
Thank you. lamp must be born until the favored child makes themselves known. Only then can the remaining carrion of creation finally return to the void. Chosen bearer of the lamp, like you, I serve. Until her embrace.
You serve a higher purpose, Crusader. To strive in darkness, in light we walk.
selfish and avaricious as Galinda is, Traveler, she is indeed skilled. And it's no small feat to smith magic-infused manacles such as the one she used to bind me to her when she found me weakened and injured. I watched the cataclysmic death of the universe, and came as close to my own death as I ever have in all my eons. Only to then find myself once again in this world. Now, slave. To countless realities, borne witness to wonders beyond measure. And yet, eventually, time numbed me to all of it. I had cast off my mortal form long ago with no regret, but I was a fool to discard my humanity. I see it now. I have a new appreciation for life, for experience, for freedom. I only desire to be free once more.
Oh, it's me. Get back to work while Galinda still has use for you.
No.